Howdy again, it's Mr. Pete, your YouTube shop teacher, and I'm all hyped up on Dunkin' Donuts coffee, and this is episode number 38 of my short subject series entitled Cutting a Chamfer. Now, there is a playlist for these short subjects, which are not all that short. You know, I don't understand these 60-second shorts that people are putting on, you know, in the vertical position. They're absolutely worthless, and I do not intend to do that, but let's get back to this. So I will be using this 45-degree Banggood chamfering cutter, and thank you for that, Banggood, and I've had this since 2018. I don't believe I ever used it, but this is what it is. 3/4-inch shank, and I put still pictures of this and all the numbers at the end if you're interested. And there is the cutter set at 45 degrees, and I have a whole box of inserts as well that I haven't touched. There's 10 of them in there, and the correct morphodite end on there for putting it on and off. Okay, now you can cut a chamfer in many different ways on the milling machine, and one certainly is to tilt the head. But as you know, I would much rather receive a severe lashing with a cat of nine tails than to tilt the head. So that's why I originally ordered this, so I would not have to suffer the indignities of a beating. Let's go over to the mill and put this in a 3/4 collet. And I'm going to mill some samples, so I'll keep this short. That's me on the floor being whipped with a cat of nine tails, and it's almost pleasureful compared to tilting the head on a Bridgeport mill. I might have said this is a 3/4 shank, but no. So I put a 3/4 collet in the machine, and this wouldn't go in. And what a pouting disappointment. Then it occurred to me, could this possibly be a metric diameter? Because it is from the big C, you know. So, yes, it is 20 millimeters, which translated to Imperial is 785, so it won't fit. What will a fella do? Well, I guess I'm going to have to take a time here off camera and turn this down, and there is a center hole here. I don't know how hard this is. Maybe I'll show a clip of that if I can set it up, but the idea here is I'd like to hold it by this if I can and support it with a center and take her down to 3/4, probably not all the way, and I do not like the idea of losing this number here, but so be it. I said I wasn't going to show this, but I guess I lied to you, but here's how I am holding it. Notice that the flute is being straddled between the two jaws, and a live center here. I like that spring-loaded one, and I already checked it for hardness, and it actually is quite soft, so it's going to turn very easily. I don't have a whole lot to take off. Well, I don't know if this is accurate enough, so I am checking it with an indicator. Actually, I already did. I'm just going to show you. So if we move in here a little bit, and I rotate the spindle, you can see that I'm within a half a thousand. So that's, for all intents and purposes, perfect. All right, let me change cutters here, and let's make some chips. Okay, here's the setup, and if you can't stand to watch this, advance it about 3 or 4 minutes, and I'll be back at the Bridgeport, I hope. Okay, here's the finishing pass, and I'm only taking off 3 or 4 thousandths, but that should bring it down to the correct dimension, 0.750. Right on the money. I'm not getting that good a finish. I probably should have switched inserts, but it's good enough for who it's for. But before I take it out, let's see if it actually fits in the collet. And yes, it does, so we're done with that little detour. Back to the Bridgeport. And finally, after the detour, we are ready to cut. I should say I am ready to cut. Now, I've never done this before, so we'll see how this works. And this is 3/4 inch thick aluminum. Okay, it's rougher than a cob because I was conventional milling, and I don't care because I'm going to take several more passes, and I haven't used lubricant. I want it to be easy for you to see. And I probably should increase the spindle speed. Okay, I have fed 50 thousandths in the x-axis, and I am climb milling. Usually gives a better cut. Actually, always gives a better cut, doesn't it? This will be my final pass. I did put a little Aluma cut on there, and I'm taking off just a few thousandths. Let's see if it cleans up. It's a little ripply. I really do not like that. I'm going to crank the spindle speed up and take one final pass. The first cut was 1100 RPM, this will be 1750. We'll see if it's any better, and I will feed a little bit slower. Quite a bit better, but still not as good as I hoped for. I've got a little ridge here, so I have to raise the table. Oh, I said that was the last cut, but one more. Good, I have cranked the cutting speed up to 2720 RPM. I'm getting serious now. You know what? I'm not impressed by this at all. I fed reasonably slow. Of course, I'm feeding by hand. It feels smooth, but it sure doesn't look good on the monitor. But then again, I do not know what this insert is designed for, whether it's steel or aluminum. So real quickly, I'm getting too long here, I'll take a couple passes on steel, but I am going to slow that back down to 1750. This is free machining lead-loist steel, so let's see what it does. 1725 RPM. Now on the aluminum block, my chamfer is a little bit over 1/4 inch. I'm going to make less of a chamfer here, which is typically what you would do. So this will be the final pass. It's rather light cut, but let's see what happens. Be sure and wear your safety glasses when you work in your shop. Feels pretty smooth. I think I'll take it out for a better look. I'm not impressed at all at what it did on the aluminum, but this is pretty darn good. I mean, you can see machining marks, but I guess that's normal. And this again is about 1/4 inch of a chamfer, which is kind of heavy cut. This only 1/8 inch, maybe a little more. And it looks pretty darn good. I'm happy with that. And the fella might go all the way around his project or whatever the drawing or your desire calls for. But it would be a good tool, and I hope that you'll see it in a lot more videos over the years, because I really forgot about it. It just kind of sat in the cabinet, and I never got around to making the video. So thanks to Banggood for that. And I had to cut the shank down, of course, so that was the detour. Did you like the video? Do you like my channel? If you do, ring that bell too. I think that would help me a lot as well. And this is Mr. Pete saying so long for now, and I'll see you in my next video. Well, I have to admit, I'm in a bit of pain right now, and the final indignity was when they threw salt water on me. But notice my assistant kindly covering my back with my torn shirt.